Hello again and welcome back. Today I'm going to show you how I built this cute little table made out of walnut and maple on this edition of Patrick's Nonsense. This little table was built as a computer stand, which is ultimately going to replace my current computer tower. Now, this new computer build will be done in a separate project from this, but for now I'm going to show you how I built this table. This is not a video about computers, but more so a table which we're going to build in support of this case right here. It'll be my new rig, which I will be using for video editing and a bunch of other cool stuff. The reason why I'm showing it in this video is we can take some quick measurements and get underway for our wooden table build. So without further ado, let's unbox this bad boy and see what we got. Alright, so I took some measurements real quick, so we have at least some quick game plan of what we want to do. And it goes something like this, maybe 12 and a half inches high at a minimum. Looks like that clipboard thingy down at the bottom. We'll see, just a quick sketch. 13 and a half inches wide, because that is my allowable room on the side of my little table, maybe 18 inches long to compensate for the depth. And there is the top. So that's my rudimentary plan, and we'll start laying out our pieces. So let's see what we got. All right, so check it out. We get some really, really quality, good material here. We're gonna make our table from walnut and hard maple. They go very, very, very well together. This is a walnut. Very dark wood, and this is maple. This, you don't get this from your regular hardwood or your Home Depot. Rather, I went to a specialty hardwood store where I got this material. This piece here is actually what I think I'm gonna make the legs out of. This is unfinished raw stock, but as opposed to this maple material right here, which has been run through a thickness planer already, that was milled perfectly, so it's beautiful wood. So let's start with that, and we'll see where it goes. Okay, with the interest in saving some precious YouTube time for this video, not to put everybody to sleep, we started out by cutting four pieces of walnut. 1, 2, 3, 4. A basically equal length. About 16 inches. This gives me a little bit of working room. And I did it on the chop saw here. So, we did it. Standard chop saw. We got some working material. And we're going to go ahead and see if we can start doing this tongue and groove on the table saw router table. Check it out. It's the first time I used this particular blade. It's the tongue and groove right there by Freud. A little set. So let's replace the blade. We are now going to cut with this different knife right here, and we are now going to cut the groove for the tongue to fit in. So. Beautiful, fits together beautifully. So let's cut our border pieces out with maple and we'll go from there. All right, what I did is I went ahead and glued the pieces together. I got four pieces of wood. These are roughly 1x4s. And I put a couple of temporary tacks
just to hold it while it dries. So I continue to build. And then I sanded it down a tiny bit just so I can move across the table. Right now, what I'm fixing to do, very carefully, I went ahead and struck a mark. You can't see it here, but on the center line. And then I figured out how to trim some off on the sides here to get my 13.5 inches. 13.5 inches is what we're going to build the table with that. But of course, don't forget, we're going to frame it. We're going to frame it with some of these pieces. So after the frame is on, we want our end result to be 13.5 inches wide. Obviously right now it's a little bit more than that, so we left some room for adjustment. So let's trim this up here and see where we're at. All right, we reset up the machine back to our router table here, and we're gonna cut the tongue on the two sides and make a few passes of that, and we'll see how it goes. We cut the groove here on all three sides, so now we can go ahead and see if it fits our frame, and then we can trim it to length. I purposely left this last one off so we can adjust for our perfect length, and then we'll go from there. We'll go. Yeah, look at this. All right, I went ahead and trimmed it up, made some adjustments here and there, tongued all the way around, and it fits perfect. I mean perfect. Okay, nice work, nice work. So let's go ahead and put some glue on it, tack it up, and then we'll trim this side to make the front, and we'll glue it a little bit later and maybe let it dry overnight, and we'll see where we're at. Cut here, trimmed up. Now we just gotta make the groove in the other one. This is gonna be the front of the table, and we're gonna shape it for our cup holder. We're gonna make it real nice. So we'll get back to that and figure out what we need to do there. All right, so here's my pieces, my raw pieces. Once we kind of put this together, we will, there we go. We'll go ahead and glue this up, and I'm gonna trim it up for accuracy here in just a minute. But we're gonna glue this up and let it sit up overnight before we sand it down and decide to shape our front. But now we are gonna concentrate on cutting the recessed hole, and then we're gonna carve it up real nicely, put a little styling on it before we sand it and route it and do all the other fancy stuff. How big do we want the recessed hole? Well, I went ahead and took an average size tumbler. This is just your this is actually an Arctica branded tumbler, but it's the same as your Ozark Trail or your Yeti cup. So how are we gonna do this? Well, I have right here actually an identical piece. This is an identical piece just like the bottom, so we're gonna stack it up, and I'm gonna actually make a template, and we're gonna use a router to go ahead and carve this out. So I measured the length from the front to the back, which is about 3 9/16 is what I measured. I went ahead and marked it up here from the edge to my markings. Now I basically got to figure out where I want it. I decided, since I'm going to be sitting where this part is faced me at any one given time of the evening, I really like my drinks to be probably on this side versus this side. I could. And cut this out with a saber saw right now, and then we'll see.
See,
our this being the template is only going to be our hole is only going to be as good as the template is, so it's real important that we go ahead and sand this out after we cut our hole with the saber saw. So I went ahead and took it to the spindle sander, so I get a real nice smooth cut because we want our cup finish to be really, really good. So, and we're going to use this bit right here, this router bit. Now, the way this router bit works is this bearing is going to follow the inside edge of the template. So as it travels around the template, it's going to cut our groove on the bottom, just like so. And so we want to be careful that we don't want to cut too deep. So I'm going to measure it. I'm going to eyeball here. And we're going to determine the depth in a minute. After we clamp these two together, we're just going to superimpose them. So it's going to be, we're going to take our plunge router. See, I have a couple of different attachments. This right here is actually a plunge attachment for our Bosch router. So it's a couple bases. One's a fixed base and one's the plunge base. We're going to switch them out. Put our bit on there, we're going to determine the depth and then go from there, and we should have a beautiful hole. So let's set that up now. Look at that. That's a real nice hole. We'll go ahead and remove our template. All right, guys. Here we go, we're gonna go ahead and wrap this thing and see what we got for the edges. We're gonna make the frame out of the same material, walnut and maple, to complement it with the contrasting colors. All right, well, I was gonna do some box cut finger joints, but I had some difficulties with my jig, and in the interest of time and cost and a bunch of other stuff, I'm missing something. I went ahead and decided to just miter it so I can finish up this project and get on with the actual computer build. So we're gonna make the legs out of this. This is actually raw stock maple. It's probably like 2x2 or something like that. Now, the top of the computer, we want it to be about level, maybe just a little bit taller than the table itself. The table's what, 30 inches, 30 and a half, something like that. So I did some math already and I figured out the top of our table needs to be around 12 and a half inches tall. So if we subtract 3/4 of an inch because of the thickness, we end up with about 11 and 3/4. So what we're first gonna do is cut our pieces so we can just get some working space, some working stock, and then we'll go ahead and true this up and figure it out from there so we end up with our beautiful legs. So, all right, so I got my pieces together. This is really just the base. Remember my legs? I took my legs and after several passes and through the table saw, I got them real nice, true, and square. I cut them all exactly the same length using another fence and a stop. So I think we're ready to start assembly. Now, there is... I'm kind of on the fence about the finish. These are a little bit of burn marks, but very light. I'm not sure how well the camera will do it justice here, but I didn't want to sand it too much to get it out of square. So what I'm going to do is I sanded it a little bit. I put them all together, and I sanded them together. I clamped them and stuff so I can get them really, really true. Now that I got them really true, I want to start with the assembly, and then after the assembly, we can come back and sand some more with some finer grit paper so we can get that finished. What I did is I got this piece of wood here. I've built a lot of stuff over the years, and I tell you what, it is so hard to get stuff perfectly square once you do final assembly. So I wanted a surface as flat as possible, and I'm going to use my square here to help me out so we can line this up when we start to glue, and maybe we can set it up. And I didn't want to try to clamp it or anything because then it would push it apart with these mitered corners. So let's just start with some glue here and get it kind of set up, and then we'll just go from there as we'll see how it goes. Been gluing this last couple hours in stages. I'd glue a piece and go do something else, come back, glue a piece, and I went ahead and carefully put two legs on. What I am doing is I'm gonna put the last two legs on here, and we're gonna glue these up before I tack it with a couple of brads. So that's kind of what I'm doing right now. So here we go, we went ahead and assembled it and glued it all together. And we have a few little brads here and there that we went ahead and sanded those smooth. So we're gonna let this dry overnight. And what we're doing now is we're applying some protective acrylic finish. This is water-based acrylic paint. It's just basically your varnish that goes over to protect the wood. We don't wanna get stains or any of that other stuff on there. And I don't really want to stain it and obscure the natural beauty of this maple and this walnut. It's a beautiful walnut here. So we're going to go ahead and just apply some of this. And first the underside, and the top part is really what matters. In the next episode, we're going to go ahead and build this computer out with some of the latest components, and we're going to show you how that's done in another exciting video of Patrick's nonsense.